as we explore quantum biology and beyond, the new science of living a longer, healthier, and more vital life, I'd like to share with you some reflections on what is commonly referred to as Darwinian evolution, the evolution of species, or as Darwin originally wrote, the evolution of species, I think, was the title of his original manuscript. Or maybe not, doesn't matter. But, you know, basically, Darwinian evolution is thought of as thought to be a result of random mutations and natural selection. And supposedly, humans are the pinnacle of this evolution. However, strict Darwinian interpretation of evolution says that evolution has no defined goals. Evolution is a blind process driven by natural selection, not a striving towards some predetermined ultimate form. What makes a species successful is its ability to survive and reproduce in its environment, not some universal measure of superiority. Also, it seems humans are still evolving. We are not the end product of evolution. Human evolution is still ongoing, and it's impossible to predict what future changes hold. Other species have remarkable adaptations. Many other species exhibit incredible adaptations and complex behaviors that make them incredibly successful in their niches. But look at us humans. We have achieved remarkable cognitive abilities. Our intelligence, creativity, and capacity for self-awareness are unique in the animal kingdom. This has allowed us to dominate the planet and achieve astounding technological and cultural advancements. As humans, we have a potential for ethical and moral development as well. So, Darwinian evolution does not actually explain self-awareness, intention, creativity, insight, higher consciousness, the desire to know our origin. All it does, it lays out a sequence of life since beginning. Probiotic evolution, early life, single-celled organisms, then eukaryotes are single-celled organisms with nucleus, then multicellular life, then diversification of life, then evolution of complex organisms, and on and on. Now, the evolution of consciousness. So I think it is natural to question strict Darwinian evolution, random mutations, and natural selection. And so when we go to the non-dual spiritual traditions, they often emphasize the interconnectedness of all things and believe in a single underlying reality beyond individual forms. And from this perspective, evolution could be seen as a progression of awareness within this non-local reality, with different species representing stages of experience and knowing. Also, today, as we look at quantum biology, some scientists explore the possibility of quantum phenomena influencing biological processes, such as, for example, photosynthesis. Without photosynthesis, there's no life on this planet. And this could suggest a deeper non-local connection between consciousness and evolution. So, is consciousness guided by evolution? Or does consciousness guide evolution? Or are they both mind and consciousness entangled in what we call the appearance of physical processes. Current science and mainstream science is anathema to the idea of anything non-physical and does not like explanations that invoke mind or consciousness. And that's why the Copenhagen interpretation right now is out of fashion, because it invokes consciousness or mind, and consciousness or mind, even though we can see the biological impact of our thoughts, which is mind, you know, every thought has a biological expression. Anger, hostility, guilt, shame, depression, anxiety, fear, love, compassion, joy, equanimity. All these thoughts, expressions of mind, have biological consequences, either in the direction of homeostasis, or we can say inflammation or disease, mental, physical, both. So even though mind has huge impact on biological processes, scientists are loath to bring mind into any explanation for the simple reason we can't measure consciousness itself. How do you measure the formless? Even though the formless is being measured as form and phenomena. And therefore, bringing mind or consciousness into arguments for or against Darwinian evolution raise eyebrows. You know, I did bring this up in a lecture I gave in India 2012 and was immediately attacked by mainstream evolutionary biologists and some of the most famous ones at that. And at that time, perhaps very little was known about neuroplasticity, epigenetics, and how experiences shape biological expression, including neural networks in the brain and gene expression. But now we have the evidence. So I think it's time to bring up this issue once again. Is consciousness guiding evolution? And does evolution ever have an end? And is the evolution of our species going beyond biological evolution? Or does biological evolution follow the evolution of expressions of experience in consciousness? So I think it was Jonas Salk who actually coined the phrase metabiological evolution, which is the evolution of consciousness and ultimately the evolution of the consciousness of our consciousness. And if we start thinking in that direction, then evolution becomes a creative process. And not in Richard Dawkins' words, the expression of a blind watchmaker or something like that. So I'm curious to know what you think. Do you think evolution is random, purposeless, or is it a creative process in cosmic consciousness? And if you're not allergic to it, in the mind of God. I think it was Einstein who said, I want to know how God thinks. Everything else is a detail. Let me know what you think.